Hey guys, Matt Thurtell from Ntrack here. We're excited to announce that Ntrack Studio 9.1 is out now on desktop and mobile and includes a powerful loop browser as well as a large amount of royalty-free loops and playable instruments. So we thought it would be useful for you guys if we produce this video, which is an overview of how to navigate the loop browser, use and import loops both on desktop and iOS and Android too. So to open up or close the loop browser, click either on the loop browser icon in Ntrack Studio here, or go to the view menu and select loop browser. The loop browser will open up, and to get to the main point, either double click or click and drag on a loop to import it into your Ntrack project. The first time you do this, you'll get a pop-up that asks if you want to match the key of the loop to the key of your song project. Select yes or no. We'll select yes. And once imported, the loop will match the tempo of your project automatically, and you're good to start building tracks. Let's do a tour of the loop browser interface. You can see the main part of the loop browser is split into three columns: loop name, BPM, and instrument group. Each of these can be ordered by clicking on the column header. So we can click on BPM, for example, to see loops in tempo order, down to up, or up to down. At the top of the browser, there's a search bar if you know the name of a specific loop, or if you want to quickly generate an idea by typing in something more general, like guitar. The waveform of a loop can be viewed in the lower part of the browser. This can be played and stopped using the play and stop buttons on the top right of the waveform. The loop can also be scrolled through by clicking wherever you want on the waveform. For those of you that require technical details of loops, you can go ahead and hit the I button on the upper left-hand side of the waveform. It will allow you to dive more into the specifics, including sampling frequency and bit rate of a loop, as well as the root key and loop tempo. The Follow Song BPM icon can be enabled at the lower right of the loop browser. With this icon enabled, a loop will automatically match the Ntrack project tempo. This is useful because you can audition sounds and see if they fit with the song you're creating at your song's tempo. In our example, the tempo of our Ntrack project is set at the default of 120 BPM. Let's hear a loop example with the Follow Song BPM icon on, playing to 120 BPM, our project tempo. And with it off, so the loop plays at its original tempo, and on again with our Ntrack project tempo, and off again. I imagine you can hear the difference. Let's continue to look over the loop browser interface. All gives an overview of the available loops and audio files, while type classes loops and audio files into three categories: loops, instrumentals, and samples. The beats category is something we're particularly excited to release because it means that rappers can get royalty-free release length beats to use and release instantly. Let's hear an example. We've also included the Ntrack sessions used to produce these beats so that producers could take it one step further and put their own mark on these instrumentals. They can be located under the projects folder. To open a project, just double click on the track name. Clicking once means that you can hear the track before you open the project as well. Let's not save the currently open project. Press play on the new Moving Mountains project. And we can hear that we can solo each part, hear them individually. And for the producers out there, you can amend these projects to your taste. Let's scroll down and click on the genres category. We can see that sounds are categorized into different musical styles, so let's have a listen to some rock category examples. Muted chords riff could easily be the inspiration for a new track. Let's listen to a drum groove too, nice and up tempo at 147 BPM. Let's try the world category. This could easily be sampled as part of a rap beat. And another example. Moving up, we'll try some pop examples too. So Club Banger sounds exactly that. And let's try some Retro's 90s synth. You get the picture, I'm sure. This loop browser is packed with hand-selected sounds across the genres to inspire and enhance your music making. Let's move down to the instruments category and listen to a few examples. So we've got some lovely vocal sounds. And these can be used royalty-free in your productions. And let's listen to a synth example. So that's a dark texture that you could start a song with easily. Let's hear some keys and move on to the BPM category. So under the instruments category in the loop browser, we can click on BPM, and this organizes every loop and audio file by its tempo. So we can see this ranges from 184 right down to 54 is the slowest tempo, and everything in between. One thing to note is that N-Track supports tempos with decimal points, so they don't always have to be a whole number, which can sometimes be useful in productions. We'll listen to a couple of examples at 80 BPM. And by enabling the follow song BPM button, we can hear that the loop matches the faster project tempo. Let's select another loop. I'm sure you can hear the difference when we deactivate the button. N-Track offers its own sample packs as free downloads and paid updates, with all available to use royalty-free in N-Track Suite Edition. The individual packs can be located here in the add-ons section. We can see three text colors. White means a pack's downloaded and ready to use. Blue means a pack's already downloaded but has new updates. Gray means a pack is not yet downloaded. And if we click on an example of this, like Drum and Bass Toolkit, the add-on manager appears and gives us the option to get the pack. To access the add-on manager, we'll go to the View menu and click on Add-on Manager. This houses all of the sample packs, and you can see these range across a variety of genres, including electronic, world, vocals, orchestral, drum and bass, rock, hip-hop, and beyond. The tabs at the top of the add-on manager filter which packs include which types of sound, either instruments, drum kits, or audio loops. And you'll notice the buttons next to the sample packs. Remove deletes an already downloaded pack. Get downloads a new pack that hasn't been installed. And if a pack has already been installed but has new changes, you'll see the update button. Moving on to My Folders, we can bring our own sounds and samples into the N-Track loop browser. WAVs, MP3s, AIFF, M4A, and FLAC audio files can all be imported. Here's an example of some drums we've recorded as WAVs and imported into the browser. So to add your own sounds, click on the Add Folder row, which will open up Finder or Windows Explorer. Locate your sounds and click Open. In this case, we're importing a folder called N-Track Acoustic Collection. We can see that this has been imported as a folder in the loop browser, and that N-Track recognizes and plays the WAV files that we've imported. Song is the final menu option in the loop browser. From this, we can see recent files, and in project files, we can quickly access the loops and sounds used in the N-Track project right now. So we can see we've got a clap sound, some vocal synths, kicks, and more. There are no files under the Recents Files row, as nothing new has been added to the project we opened earlier from the Beats Projects category. To demonstrate how this works, let's choose a random loop. Four on the door will do. Let's add it to the project. And returning to the Recents Files row, we can see that Four on the Door has been added. For this example, let's use Melks Rollins Keys, which we can hear is playing at its original 92 BPM in the loop browser. We'll import this loop into our N-Track song, and we can see the project is set at 120 BPM. We're hearing that the loop is automatically imported at 120 BPM, matching the speed of our N-Track project. A drop-down menu appears if you click on the upper right-hand side of a loop. At the bottom part of this drop-down, we can deselect Follow Song BPM to return the loop to its original tempo within the main N-Track project. Let's hear an example of that. We can also re-enable Follow Song BPM in the same way. Let's hear the loop return to the project tempo of 120 BPM. Clicking again on the drop-down menu, we can see that above follow song BPM, you can also enable and disable the loop matching the key of the N-Trap project. You can also pitch shift the loop without the need for any plugins, which we think is cool. Let's hear an example of the pitch shift at B4. And at E5. The note with the asterisk is the original key of the loop, so let's return to that. To give you guys all the options, we can click on the I button to go to part properties. If the part properties section of the window doesn't show, it's because you need to actually select the part in the N-Trap project. We can see that under musical info, we can adjust the original loop BPM or original loop key, which is quite powerful in itself if you guys ever deal with metadata. Scrolling down, we also have the option to follow song musical key and follow song BPM here as well. And it's also worth mentioning that part speed is automatically labeled on the lower left part of an audio loop when follow song BPM is enabled. Click on the I button again, or double click on the gray area of the part to close part properties. And that's it for this overview part of the loop browser. Check out our other videos on building a song using the loop browser and any of the sample pack walkthroughs, all of which are included in N-Trap Studio's Suite Edition. As ever, please give this video a like, subscribe, share it, and above everything, just let us know how you're getting on with the loop browser. We hope you're having as much fun with it as we are. Cheers.